What's going on, everyone? Welcome to another run here in American Truck Simulator. Today, I'm back in the Viper 2 389, but I've got it dressed up on the inside as a 379. Now, depending on the angle here, I thought I had a nice color picked up, but... see, there's the matte color. The purple, blue, violet. Yeah, it's a more like a violet. But anyway, doing a quick run today here, leaving Truckee at the cat location, and where's my map? There it is. You're just gonna head down 80 to 5 and then end up jumping off so we can hit this cat location here. I wonder if I should come in from the north. I think I should come in from the north. There we go. We'll give it a shot and see what happens. So, that is the game plan. Not too long of a run here. Now that just bumped it up to 6 hours, where originally it was around 4. So let's get moving here. Yeah, I like that matte look on this thing. That does look nice. I was going for more of a blue, but it came out more purple. But went for basically a basic truck here, so a few upgrade options, as you can see here, with the bumper and the headlights and steps, things like that. But other than that, nothing too crazy, you know? Yeah, that should do just fine. All right. I do have a, Caterpillar C15-500 underneath the hood. As you can see, the badge right there, Cat Power. Of course, there's the oil pressure and brake pressure lights. Of course, this truck here is not set up for 1.6. Now, speaking of 1.6, it was brought to my attention that, at least with one person anyway, I have not heard from others, but that possibly Tom Dooley's truck does not work on the recent update. Thursday, ATS updated, and I got a message saying, hey, it's not working, what's wrong? Well, first off, I don't know what's wrong. I don't have your PC, I don't have your game, I don't know what you have going on, and even if I did know what you had going on, you know, I don't know what's wrong. So, as always, I said, you know, try it on a blank profile, no other mods, you know, play detective, figure it out. And then replied back was, oh, the game updated. Is that what's causing the issue? I really don't know. So, if you guys have any issues with Tom Dooley's 1.6, as you saw, it worked for me. When I came into the game here, I still had the truck. I sold it off to purchase this one. I had no issues. I didn't get in and drive it, but at least my profile loaded, the game loaded, all was well. So, yeah, I got nothing. But, you know, as always, guys, if you're having issues with a mod, and it's maybe it's one that I showed off or not, it doesn't matter. Do the detective work. You know, go to a clean profile. It doesn't even have to be a main profile that you use. Just let it be a profile that you can access any of the trucks or option parts, whatever. So that means you're probably going to put some time into it. Or use cheat engine to unlock everything. Or, hell, even download one of those completed profiles that you see on mod sites and use one of those. Chances are it's going to have a boatload of money and everything's going to be unlocked, so you're golden, you're good to go. But, you know, do that, put the mod in there, see if it works, and then go from there. If it works, then obviously you've got a mod conflict and there's another mod causing issues. If it doesn't work, then clearly the mod is not ready for whatever version of ATS that you have. No, I don't want that one. I forgot they put in the I-99 thing right there. I don't want to go that way, but I should go that way one of these days, because that is part of the MHApro edition there, so I'd really like to take that off ramp. But the problem, I don't know what the problem is. So, you know, always do your own detective work, guys. I can't help you out with everything. I do my best, but yeah, I am limited in what I know and what I can do. So, moving on. I get the feeling for some people yesterday as well, I handled multiple messages. I get the feeling that some people kind of misunderstood what I was saying about going to Twitch. I'm not going to Twitch full time. It's only for the live streams. That's it. I will still be putting videos up on YouTube like I do right now. And all live streams, hello, how you doing? Why are you basically stopping like an idiot? And that was my idiot move going down to third. Oh, Walmart. But anyway. Yeah, I'm still going to be uploading videos here like normal. Nothing's going to change there. All live streams are over on Twitch will show up here on the channel the following day, so you guys are not going to be missing out. Even if you don't go to Twitch and you don't follow me there, you will still be able to enjoy the live stream videos like you do here on YouTube the following day. So no worries on that one, guys. So if you're not on Twitch, go sign up. It's free. And on top of that, I cannot use the option yet. I am not a partner. From my understanding, you need to be a partner in order to use the subscribe feature. Twitch has, and I believe it's $4.99 a month, something like that. You can subscribe to your favorite Twitch person. Now, you can subscribe to multiple. You're not limited to just one. But you can subscribe to multiple, to whatever Twitch live streamer you like. And that usually awards you special benefits and, you know, chat stuff and subscriber-only chat and things like that. Every live stream person is going to have their own little thing, I guess. It's something I have to look into as well so I can get a better understanding. But anyway, if you guys had... Really? Thank you. If you guys have Amazon Prime, Amazon Prime allows you one monthly subscription for free. So if you've got someone on there, it doesn't matter if it's me or someone else, if you guys got someone on Twitch that you like watching and you're a member of Amazon Prime, you can link all that up and you are able to go ahead and subscribe to someone on Twitch for free. You don't have to worry about it. Amazon Prime is going to pick up that cost. Now, if you go for more than one person, then obviously you're going to have to pick up the cost for that other one. But nice little thing there. I didn't really know about that. So there you go. But like I said, it's probably going to be a while until I am able to get partnered. I've heard so many different things about Twitch as far as what it takes to be a partner there. It's not something I am in a rush for, so I don't think I mentioned that last night, but yeah. I am not in a hurry to become partnered on Twitch. I'm not going to apply for a while, so, you know, there is no reason to be concerned or to think anything, you know, other than I believe Twitch is going to provide a better platform for the live streams, as well as a broader reach for me and whatever videos I do live stream, whether it's 7 Days to Die, iRacing, American Truck Sim, ETS, doesn't matter. And so that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking to broaden my horizons. So bring more people into the family here, and, you know, so we all just continue to do what we love doing, which is watching these videos, watching, enjoying American Truck Simulator, enjoying 7 Days to Die, learning new things about whatever games that I'm playing or we're playing, and, you know, just generally share that knowledge and that info and have fun. I mean, bottom end of the day, it doesn't matter who you like on YouTube, who you like on Twitch. Do you enjoy watching what you watch? Do you enjoy playing the same games that the people who you are watching are playing? If you enjoy it, then, you know, hey, win-win, right? So, other than that, yeah, I'm not leaving YouTube, just YouTube Live, you know. Because the other problem is I noticed this on Wednesday when I streamed last. Normally, apparently YouTube puts me onto YouTube Gaming. And so, Wednesday, I changed that up to regular YouTube, and I posted that link. The view count was actually higher than it has been when it was under YouTube Gaming. And I've heard people complain about YouTube Gaming for a while and how it just never really panned out. You know, it never really worked the way YouTube apparently, or Google apparently, imagined it would. You know, until YouTube and Google can figure out what exactly they want to do and how they're going to do it, yeah, I think I'm just going to, you know, say thanks, you know, it's been fun, I'm going to go over here now, and when you guys figure out, you know, what you want to do and how you want to do it, and you're going to actually leave it that way and not change it up, you know, then, you know, throw your support behind something, and then 2 months later, you know, flavor of the month, basically, oh, we're going to do this, and the next month it's something else. So, Twitch knows what they're doing. It's been working for a long time. It's growing. So, yeah, I'm looking for something that's going to be more stable, and that's going to provide it. It's also going to provide a better atmosphere for you guys, a better viewing platform for you guys. So I'm looking forward to it. I'm still learning a lot of the things about it. There's a lot to learn here, and so I've got to try to read up as much as I can, try to remember as much as I can, and that's the problem, trying to remember it. That's half the battle for me. But hopefully you guys make the move over there with me, and we continue to enjoy. Liking that paint on here. I am liking how this thing looks. Simple, clean. Oh, so what else do we have going on here? Oh, there is a Coronado out. I don't know how public it is. I have not seen it on any mod sites as I record this, but it has been released into one or two groups on Facebook. So before I go and show it off here, I want to get the okay, the thumbs up, to make sure, okay, yeah, I can share it with others, because I really don't want to get myself in hot water for doing that. But yeah, there's a new update to a Coronado. It's improving on the old version, so it's been updated to 1.6. Come on, really? But yeah, hopefully I can show that one off here as well soon. The FLB I've got planned to come up very soon here with a new trailer from ZRTR. So hopefully I'll be showing that one off soon. Lots of stuff that is out there, and I plan on showing you guys really soon here. Possibly another map mod. I do have the Viva Mexico, I believe it's called, in my arsenal here, but I have not looked at it yet. What else do I have here? I think the Can-Am Dream updated as well, and you need coast to coast. So I'm tempted to kind of take a look at all that again, see what kind of changes and what kind of improvements have happened to the mod in the last year. I've seen some decent screenshots, so as my head tracker goes nuts, there it goes again. Oh, it's summertime, people. That means it's staying brighter out later. So it's either I start recording these later at night, or I turn head tracker off. I should get the Pro. Pro uses the LEDs, I believe. Y'all can probably hear my dog in the background all excited and happy. My wife just got home from a doctor's appointment, so of course he's, you know, happy little camper, all excited about it. I'll be trying to cut out as much as I can, but I know some of it will come through. Is there a road there? Oh wait, I gotta turn there. I'm not used to not seeing the arrows, the barricades. I don't believe I have a mod that turns that off, so I don't know if MHApro does that or not. I've noticed it for a while. No barricades. Might as well also show you a little late. Better late than never, though. The load here. There we go. Iron pipes, 41,000 pounds, going to Sacramento Caterpillar. This is the construction site that's over here. For a few minutes, eh? Couldn't go over a little bit more on this side. Oh, did I make the right call coming in from this way? Yeah, it took a little longer, but I don't have to mess with trying to turn around, and it makes it a whole lot easier. That's half the battle sometimes. Trying to figure out just how exactly you're going to get into a place. When I was making my routes, when I was driving in the city, that was key. And I was questioning out about dispatching my bosses and whatnot. You know, why are you going this way? And, you know, well, you know, because if I go up Western Avenue this way, there is no way for me to get into this place. You know, and then, or once I leave this Jiffy Lube here, on Irving Park Road, I've got to go over to this one over here, and I can't turn out that way, or, you know, going out this way is a lot smarter because I don't have to cross rush hour traffic, and, you know, it, knowing where you're going and how to get in there and everything, especially when you're doing route stuff, that really saves a lot of time, a lot of hassle. So, alright, wait a minute, okay. I do have the trailer brake set up here, but only one of them popped out. Okay. Turn that off so I don't continue to make everyone freak out. And we're all set. Parked. Ready to drop. Ready to call it a day. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Make sure you check the mods list for these trailers and this Fontaine Phantom pack as well. It's been out for a long time. 53 footer. I thought there was a 48 footer, but I could be wrong. But yeah, 53 footer here with the that thing is, that barrier wall, it's drawn a blank what the official name is. But that is it for now, guys. Make sure you follow me over there on Twitch so you don't miss any live streams. Also Facebook and Twitter as well. Like those pages. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Leave a thumbs up if you did. I'll see you guys in the next run. Thanks for watching. Much appreciated. Until next time, take it easy.